This is the before picture. For some time now, when people in town wanted to hide the equipment required for a cell site, they would cover up the gear with a fiberglass cylinder like this, called a shroud. The problem with that approach is that in order to do any work on the site, you have to hire a crane to get the shroud off. Painful, expensive, problematic. So the clever folks at Communication Structures and Solutions came up with a way to cover up the gear, but still let you get to it when you need to. They call it a super shroud. And Legacy was brought in to put up some of the first ones. So the pieces arrived at our shop in Gig Harbor, and we started building the upgraded site that the shroud would be covering, consisting of 6 antennas and the electronics to feed them. Kind of looks like a miniature space station at this point, doesn't it? We got most of the wiring in and got the spoked mounting collars for the shrouds attached to the mast, but the rest of that assembly would need to happen on site. So the day came to head for the city and make it happen. First, we had to take down the old shroud and decommission the old site. So we got one section of the old shroud rigged, and bit by painful bit, we got the annoying thing apart, and the crane brought that section down. Then we did the same thing with the other section. Next, we rigged the top of the mast and cut it loose and brought down the old gear all at once. The next day, back at the shop, we loaded up the new cabinet housing the DC power plant and baseband units, the new cables, and the mast with all the new gear on it, and headed back up to the city. We got both surfaces prepared for welding, and once we cut out the old base plate, then it was time. We had the crane lift the new mast up above it all, and then set it down in place, and got it welded on securely all the way around. It takes just 2 of these hybrid cables to get both the power and fiber up to the site. So we fed the far end down the pole and under the sidewalk to the control center, where the site was integrated and on air. Then, back at the shop, it was time for some of the super shroud components. We loaded up the rings and the panels and headed up once more. There were 4 rings for this site, and each one of those was hoisted up and carefully guided down over the new mast and then bolted onto the collar mounts. There's a top and bottom ring for each of the 2 sections, 1 fixed and 1 rotating. And once those were all in place, then one by one, we brought up the special fiberglass panels, lifted them up and over, and bolted them into place. First, for the lower shroud covering the radios, adding the hinge pins for the pivoting sections, and then for the upper shroud covering the antenna.
We did it.
And now, whenever the time comes for an upgrade, we won't have to call for a crane. We'll just be able to open the door and rotate the opening around to wherever we need it. Now that's what I call a better mousetrap. And here's what it looks like, all painted and finished. We love new technology. Score another one for Team Legacy.